Shall we begin? Now, I like the standard Triumph mirrors, but for me, they have one shortcoming. And that's that in order to adjust them so that I can see the relevant part of the road behind me, I have to put up with at least a third of the glass being covered by my elbows. So I knew right from the start I was going to have to replace them, and that I would probably have to replace them with some sort of bar end mirror. Now, bar end mirrors have experienced a bit of a comeback over the last few years, especially with the growth in popularity of the modern classic bikes made by the likes of Triumph. But I found them to either be too expensive, with stuff like Rizoma charging up to £200 a mirror, including the fitting kit. And even the Triumph items, the best part of £100 each with the finishing kits. Or, they don't look the part. Now, Triumph spent a lot of time and effort styling the new T120 on the original 1959 model. And for me, the sharp, anodized laser cut bar end mirrors that most of these companies have on offer just don't look right. Now, there are a few companies making retro styled or classic styled mirrors, but this definitely is not one of them. This is the Halcyon 830 classic bar end mirror, and when they say classic, they mean classic. This design originally went into manufacture as far back as 1934 by the then well-known Stadium Motorcycle Accessory Company. And the only change to the design over the years was back in the early 1960s, when the original rectangular mirror head was replaced for this round one. The original base metal construction has now been replaced with an all stainless steel construction, so you can be sure this isn't going to rust over time. The current manufacturers, Halcyon, have retained the original spring-loaded glass mounting system, which means if you're unfortunate enough to break the glass, you don't have to replace the whole mirror head. Halcyon can supply you with a new glass and a spring if you need it. They have a range of bar end mountings for this mirror, which means it can be fitted to most modern motorcycles. And the actual mirror arm is mounted on a spring-loaded swivel, which allows you to adjust it to any position you want, or just to move it out the way if you're parking it in a tight space. Now, the ton-up boys of the cafe racing era would have been very familiar with this very model, and it would have been a regular sight outside the Ace Cafe back in the day. Now, with its polished stainless finish that looks as good as any chrome you're going to come across, this mirror is going to look good on any modern classic bike. But it's not just a pretty face, it's actually a very practical mirror. The ability to adjust the arm outwards gives you superior visibility behind, and at normal speeds there's no detectable vibration at all. It's only on the Bonneville in top gear when you get up to 70 miles an hour that you can just detect a faint buzz in the image, but it's still crisp and clear. Despite the UK's pothole-strewn roads and uneven road surfaces, that swivel hinge that I thought might be a problem handles the bumps and the knocks with ease. And although the mirrors do increase the width of the bike by a few inches, filtering still isn't a problem because you can just fold them in. Now, I've put this mirror through its paces for over a week, and to me it seems to perform better than most modern mirrors, but then the penny dropped. Looking back to its origins, it was designed for suspensionless motorbikes driving on unmetalled roads. So I took it to Hull's Old Town and put it through its paces on the old cobbled high street, which I don't think has been resurfaced since the 1600s.
This is not a drill.
Repeat, this is not a drill.
that all you got?
Now, it is fair to say that the camera car and the camera that it was carrying struggled with this, and the Bonneville didn't fare much better. But the mirror kept its composure, and yes, there was some movement, but you could still clearly see what was behind you. Now, currently, these mirrors are retailing on Halcyon's own website for just under £42 each, with the custom adapter for the Bonneville coming in at an extra £7.50 per mirror. For what you're getting, I think that is extremely good value, especially when you look at the quality of these mirrors. And I'll leave a link in the video description. Now, I hope you found this video useful. I will be doing a follow-up video just to show you how quick and easy these mirrors are to fit. Try not to miss it, and I'll see you next time. Oh, for sure.